I've lost. Is my English that horrible? No, just sounds like you're tired. What I said originally was, when it comes to Minecraft, it'll either be in January or in February. By being in that month, that doesn't necessarily mean the first day of that month. It means there is a time in that month that it will reside. Oh, you just got up for a nap?
Welcome back! I hope your search for my missing snow globe is going better than my search for a decent glass of wine in this place.
It is, actually. Not that I don't need to keep trying. And of course, perhaps I should slow down. It wouldn't do to get so tipsy now, would it? Yes, I got your damn snow globe, girl. Well, let me see. I must examine it to be certain that this is the snow globe that was stolen from me. Hold on. What about my reward? Ah, reward. Yes, of course. Give me the snow globe, and I will tell you where to find one of the words of power. But first, I must verify that the snow globe is truly the one I seek. Snow globe's pretty valuable to you. I think I should get some coin for its return. I'm sorry, Wade, but by rights, the snow globe is mine. I will not pay to have my own property returned to me. But you... She's already being paid to be here to find the word of power. Yet she had her property stolen when she tried to steal somebody else's property. Yet had me go seek it with no value except for her telling me that she'll give me the word of power, even though she was already contractually obligated by Aaron to do so. I'm getting screwed here. Got back from London yesterday. Nice! So I take it London was fun. Besides, I know how badly Aaron Ginn desires the words of power. If you want to recover it from him, you will give me the snow globe. Forget it. As you wish. I doubt the globe will... if it is, I'll be here waiting for you. Come on, damn it. Right. Damn it. Forget it. Wait, hang on. Damn it. Hang on. I'm gonna get this. Ah! There we go. Okay. Maybe it's the wine talking, but I like you. I suppose I could afford. Deal. 300 gold. Now, let me see. Yes, this is it. Snow globe Nax stole from me. Well done. Now, put it somewhere safe. Okay. Fun, but there was just way too many people this time of year. That's about right. Funny man went to New York this year, and I guess she's still over there. Because she went over there to see her parents, and then she's spending the week there up until New Year's. And I guess foot traffic alone, normally you can get around pretty easily by foot or by train, right? Really don't take buses. You could take a bicycle, it's kind of dangerous. But she's like, yeah, it took me about like an hour to walk, which should have been like 15 minutes. Just because of foot traffic. Thank you for everything. Yeah, I figured. Also from New York. It's busy. It's New York City, so naturally, people are getting ready for New Year, so naturally, right? Never fear, Wade. I have merely transitioned the snow globe to its pedestal in my room here at the inn, using the command word. Now that I'd done this before, Nax could have stolen it from me. But it seems I was a little tipsy that night. Now, as promised, I will tell you how to find the word of power. The key, as you may have already guessed, is the snow globe itself. Researched the snow globe in great detail, and I've discovered something rather interesting. Within the globe, there exists an entire miniature world, a real world with real living creatures. Okay, and what does this have to do with the power? If the ancient texts and documents I've researched are accurate, I'm gonna send in one of the words of power inside the miniature world. Okay, get me in. Snow globe is on the pedestal in my room, second door on the left, at the top of the stairs. If you're determined to go inside, all you gotta do is touch it. Oh, and if you want to go after the word of power, be my guest. Just head up onto my ruin and, yeah. Keep in mind, it's dangerous. Wanted to get my snow globe back, and now that I have intent to celebrate with silver glasses of the tavern's best vintage. Woo! Why went right through my head. Strong stuff. Yeah, apparently. All right, let's go. What are my plans for tomorrow? Absolutely nothing. I don't celebrate New Year's. Yeah. I celebrate Christmas, I celebrate Halloween, I celebrate birthdays, but any other, well, and occasionally we'll celebrate Valentine's Day, but I do not celebrate Easter, I do not celebrate New Year's. I don't, it's not my thing.
Okay, ducky.
Wait, was the door on the right? Wait, wait. What door was it?
Okay, ducky.
Okay, so she said one of the doors. Oh, I know. I realize what day it is, what year it'll be, but I am not of the mood. I don't see the value. Yeah. Oh! It's not really much of a thing. Yeah. So globe floats above the magical pedestal. Within the globe, you see small moving shapes moving. Now, I will say, 20 years ago, I did celebrate the year 2000. Partly because that in and of itself was actually something unique. But every year after that, nah. Again, I'm not much for New Year's. Yeah. I know a number of my friends who get really excited. They dress up. They go to every single bar. Back to wherever. Oh, hi. Object is busy, can't talk right now. Object is busy, can't talk right now. Welcome, half-old friend. Your kind is strange to us. We are used to seeing only the dwarves and they attack us on sight. Why did the dwarves attack you? The dwarves are insane with bloodlust. There's no other explanation. They cannot be reasoned with and they slaughter our kind with no remorse. Oh. I'd like to ask you a few questions. I will do my best to help you. But it is answers you seek. You must speak with Arwil. He's the wisest of the dryads. Oh, well then, I will go speak to Arwil. Bye-bye. I'll be honest. Haste? Oh, so good. And you are Arwil.
I am Arwil, leader of the dryads. I bid you welcome. Your kind is strange to us. We are used to seeing only the dwarves who attack us on sight.
You only have the next duplicate year numbered on 3030. Yeah, For what reason have you sought me out, half-orc? Some boon you must ask me? So why are the dwarves at war with you? The dwarves cannot be reasoned with. They slaughter my sisters and chop down my trees. They cut my trees. They chop down our trees. It is as if they are possessed by a kind of madness. Oh, I understand what that means. It's divisible by 10, but again, eh. And yet sometimes I feel the dwarves are not solely to blame. I do not speak of this with my sisters, but there are times when things are not clear, as if I am a dream or a nightmare. I have dark visions of me and my sisters unleashing our magic on the dwarves and reveling in the slaughter. I cannot help but wonder if we dryads do not sometimes succumb to the same bloodlust as our foe. Have you always been at war? I think not, though it is hard to remember anything else. Within my mind, there are fleeting images of a time long, long ago, a time when dwarf and dryad stood side by side. We were slaves to a terrible master, a monstrous creature of pure evil. Dwarf and nymph alike served this being, and together we dared stand against it. Memories are clouded and unclear, a trembling reflection in a muddled pond. Perhaps they are not even real, for it seems as if our war with the dwarves has raged since the dawn of existence. I mean, 80 years is a very, very long time. So, yeah. Unless something very unique happens within those 80 years that allows humans to either prolong their life or alter their existence in a very particular way to allow for a longer life. I'm gonna ask you some questions. how can this world exist inside a snow globe? Forgive me, but I do not understand your question. I know nothing of this snow globe of which you speak, and our world is as it is. Oh. We know no other life but this one of constant endless war with the dwarves. Okay. Immortal. The true horror of this war is that it can never end. The dwarves we slay are reborn and venture forth to wage war upon us again, just as we are reborn after each and every death. A thousand times I have felt the cold steel of a dwarven sword pierce my flesh, or had my skull broken by their great warhammers. Yet each time I reappear once again in this grove. So you're immortal. Our life is one of endless suffering and hate. We feel the pain of death and the horrors of eternal war, but for us there is no escape. I know not how we came to be, but though I know our existence is wrong. Okay. Do you know anything more about the dwarves? Greater ones are enraged with battle lust. Okay, that's all they have for that. Let's try the other side of the map. Now watch, I walk up and I can talk to... Never mind. I was going to say I can walk up and probably talk to this man. Nope.
The dwarves is for the dwarves.
And what if I was a dwarf? Eh? Would you hurt your own kind, Hod? I mean, that might be a thing down the road. We never know, Super. Holy biscuits! Okay, he just critted for 48. Are you... You're effortless, and yet... Ouch. I feel like this game has a bit of an issue with difficulty spikes. Just a wee bit. Oh, he's back! Oh my god! Oh, that is. I didn't realize he was gonna respawn that quickly. Okay, that goes. That leaves. Oh, they're all back. Well, my AC is whopping 29 right now. And as a monk, you can't wear anything heavier in terms of armor. So, also, we're about ready to ding too, which is nice. I think I need more wisdom. Yeah. Wisdom or dex? Arwul's journey. Hod's journal. Okay. The dwarves fell upon us yet again. The savagery was terrifying. Oh, he's already on it? Okay, good, dumb. But at last, I and my sisters managed to drive them off. How many times was I slain in that battle only to be reborn and slain yet again? Does it even matter anymore? War, death, rebirth, the cycle never ends. In my dreams, there are visions of a different world. I see dwarf and dryad working together, allied against a common and terrible foe in a bid to escape the pointless existence. And I remember the whisper of a powerful talisman, a tool to free both dryad and dwarves, the Amulet of Ages. This is a beautiful memory of a time long forgotten, or a promise of hope for the future. We could only speak with the dwarves and make them understand. But they are mad with bloodlust and attack us on sight. I fear this gruesome cycle will continue forever, and this brutal existence will never end. Alright, what about him? The dryads came at us again, using their foul magic. The fighting was bloody fierce, but at last we drove the tree huggers back. How many times did I die in that battle only to be reborn and slain again? Fighting death, rebirth, fighting, it never ends. Amulet of Ages. Is it a memory of a time lost or a hope for the future? If the dryads would only listen to reason, then maybe. If they're mad and attack us on sight, the fighting will never end. Okay. So they're cursed. That's a dragon. How dangerous are you? Kinda dangerous.
Visitors are a great curiosity in my world. So I will tell me if you will. Why have you come to my world?
I'm searching for the words of Bawa. Hang on. I think I'm gonna do a little bit of reverb here. I'm gonna drop this down. I think I got this right.
That is something with which I am familiar. There was a time when I learned that stuff about the resistance that gained even mentioned the word in my presence.
Well, are you saying I'm stupid? About to give away your 2DS. What question is, Super, do you actually use your 2DS still? Oh, you lost. Okay, I can see that, yeah. Where is the word now?
The magic of the words is saying it is wrong in my life. It is never there. All in this seminar. What is fire? Don't you ever have.
Ah, so it's a fight you won. Is there nothing I can offer in exchange for the word? What if I just take it from you?
Then you would die in an eternity. Not that level would be on your soul. Blood my veins is just the page and slow and boil. My anger is forever once again.
Give me the word or die.
I have suffered for you to know.
Ooh. Ah. It's a big dragon.
You are
so gonna gill him. I am.
I love this part.
Somehow not able to hit the dragon. I can't hit the dragon. Ooh, I got the dragon. Ah! Okay. Bad idea. Way bad. At the very least, tell me I've done some. Okay, now I'm hitting him. Guardian White Dragon. Woo! Whoosh! Am I dead? Nope, not dead.
Hello to you.
Hello. Lenu, I'm gonna grab you instead. I'm gonna go talk to our little boy over here. Nurik! Give me some healing. I was sorry about when I explained it. She thought it was just a toy for kids, like little kids. She gave me this one with Jakun back in the day. Oh, that sucks. Had my grandma do something similar. It was a bit on the rough side when she did that, to be honest. Okay, hold on. So apparently, Dragons are dangerous. Are you shitting me? Fear right out the bat. Woo! All right, boy. That's death magic. That's the fear belt. Okay. I wish they didn't have fear. I really wish they didn't have fear. Oh, yep. I think I'm dead. Yep. I wish I could move. Nope. I'm on the ground. At least run away. Wait, am I in control? No? Nope. Zip? He's just standing there. I'm dead. And so we attain. Give me a second. I go grab the tier 3 tiara. Give me a second. What's cute is when they actually sent this tiara, by the way, they actually sent this. Sent in a box. Biscuits. Alright. Didn't even pull off the shrink wrap yet. I was thinking, like, did we ever go against any dragons? Excuse me. In Baldur's Gate, and as far as I can remember, no. Yeah, like we I don't think we actually ever encountered any dragons in Baldur's Gate that I remember. I believe that might have been like endgame content for like later. So, this is my first time actually coming after. We're going after a dragon in D&D because we never, ever, this is actually kind of heavy, like ever, went after it because we never got high enough level to go after a dragon. So, yeah. All right. How does this work? Like that. Shit. I think I feel like this is staying in play, but it feels like it's trying to pop off. Let's see here. Is that? That's that. That's that. Okay, so give me one chicken. I wonder if I can make a. I realize these are, make a small group here. There we go. New group. And I'm gonna put that group in there. That group in there. And then I'm gonna move that down. There we go. Oh, that looks terrible! There we go. Oh yeah, a little bit better. Brats on the points. It does. I was not expecting to have to whip this bad boy out for this game, but apparently I do. All right, so he's gonna throw a really nasty spell at us, and I am debating. There's a belt that might mitigate that. Yep. I'm gonna buy it. Cause this has, it's basically split it. Do I have enough to buy the greater? 89. Come on. There we go. Okay, cool. All right, this should be the greater. I'll go ahead and put this bad boy on. Go and save it and watch. It doesn't really matter. Let's see the crown jewels in London. Like a way to do this where it doesn't hurt. There we go. Two-hour queue. Oh, dude, I imagine. All right, here we go. Right out the gate, he's just gonna wallop me. Okay, so do... Oh, God. Oh, she's just speared. Okay, there's no way I can help her with that? I'm not hitting him. He's a big ass dragon and I'm not punching him. Okay, whoop. Yep, teleport, 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 teleport! Or die. I guess it's death. Okay, so right out the gate, this guy's gonna use... Let's go grab Charwin. She might help out with the bards. Depends. Are we thinking full set? Are we thinking, well, I shouldn't say full set. I should say, I think we're thinking, are we thinking armors for parties? Or are we thinking armor for combat? Because there's two separate weights for that. Typically, there were. Okay, there we go. Dr. Charwin here. Because from what I remember, it was for combat. It was... They were actually full on wearing armor. It was like a good 85 pounds. If not up to, I think, 115. But as combat, as blacksmithing techniques got better, armor got lighter. Also, fun little fact, this is really weird. At a certain point, after a while, when armor wasn't really primarily used in combat like that anymore, and it became more like a parade of armor, things started to change in that they would have a cup, a dingle doggle, and then over time, that like they would make the cup longer and bigger and longer and bigger to the point where it was just ridiculous. If you look at some of the armor types, it's clearly, you know, fabricating something. Okay, so I'm gonna rest. I'm gonna pop a few potions here and wanna see if this will work. Because as far as I can tell, punching a dragon doesn't work. Who knew? I did not realize that punching a dragon is just hard to punch a dragon. All right. I believe... Yeah. Aid? Al wisdom? That's grace. Move your body. Well, no. Honestly... We tend to believe that, like, even cave, like, most people were, like, really, 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 really buff in those cases. No, actually wasn't really the case. Your average body type was typically what they had. Let me, shut the door here as... Oh, maybe not. Okay, scratch that. I feel like if I move, this thing's gonna come right off. Ow! You know what? Hang on. It is, like, not even on there, is it? Alright, can I, like... Hey, I can! Okay, it's like bending the metal a little bit to make it a little bit easier. Like a petite tiara from some ladies. Alright, try this again. Typically, your average height was, if I remember correctly, like 5'2 to 5'6. 5'6 being on the 5'6 to 5'7 was actually considered tall back then. Like, if you were 5'6 or 5'7, you had like a regal statue to yourself. If they saw somebody like by our standard of height, what we consider tall, they would be a giant. Yes, they were small. Even when you look at the past 100 years in older houses, staircases were smaller because foot size was smaller too. Really weird because my house has itty bitty steps that I swear to God are just too dangerous for people. And mom's like, oh, back then, fine. So, and she's not wrong. Hey, bending it a little helped out. Yeah, it's actually pretty comfortable for a tiara. Which is a weird thing to say. It's like, yeah, it's pretty comfy. Do I not have bark skin? Nope, I don't have bark skin. Okay. Move your body here and now and that. Okay. We have a dragon! Hey, I finally hit it! Oh god, and it hit me! Whoosh! So I went to look online for how people handle this game in hard mode and beyond. This is how you fight it. This is actually literally how you do it, is you just go back and forth and hope to God you have enough money to go back and forth. That's it. That sounds cheatsy doodles, but like they didn't intend it to be any other way. Come on, get up. Get up, buddy, get up! Oh my god. Well, see, when you fight something like this, you're in a party, right? A party of four or five to fight a dragon. It's very rare to be in a party of one or two. And it seems like what BioWare was trying to do is, like, I imagine they wanted people to do this because it's multiplayer. You can play this as a group, right? There's multiplayer component online. And there's also DMing where you can use the in-game engine to make your own levels, make your own campaigns, blah, 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 blah. Dragons probably scale for four people, and I'm fighting it essentially by myself because Sharwin, my allies are getting immediately feared. So all the stats for this dragon are probably tooled for two to three to four people. I feel like they are. Because if it's tooled for one person, holy shit, either I screwed up in terms of monk or monk's just not really good at fighting dragon. Back to wherever. The good news. We are hitting him. He's barely injured. There we go. Whoosh. Come on. No. Oh, God. I hit the whoosh button and he hasn't. I'm dead. I'm dead. Son of a biscuit. I have no idea how to, like, stop her from, like, being feared now.
Yes. Is there something you need?
Distance. Far. So bad. Well, I got a hit in. Get up, buddy. Get up. Get up. What am I doing? What is he doing? I'm immune to fear, but I can't move. Gotta go. I'm dead. No, he's dropping. Why are you dropping on your knees? What is causing you to drop? It's fear. He's attacking, and it's forcing me to go to my knees. I don't know why, but it is. Oh, I don't suppose you have bark skin as a potion, my sir, my friend. Clarity, like, I am fighting a dragon. It was a bad idea. Hit the save button. I'm gonna run out of money. Come on, buddy. Hit him. Hit him. Hit him. Hit him. Can we knock down a dragon? Can I knock down a dragon? Nope. Oh, I'm on the ground. I'm on the ground. Oh, I'm on the ground. Ah! Drink a potion. Woo! Not enough. The white dragons are among the weakest of the worms of Faerun. Particular specimen's enormous size indicates it is a great age and formidable power. Wait, so you are weak? I can barely hit you. Immune to knockdown, mind paralysis, damage immunity, decrease, fire, increase. Hold. Damage reduction. Spell resistance increase. I can't merely just set your ass on fire. Back to wherever. Is that the chest?
Sorry.
Woo! No, 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 no. No, stop attacking. Jarwin. I love how she's doing nothing. She's just constantly feared, which is a terrible thing. Oh, God. Dash it.
My attack is denied.
What? Okay, Sharwin. How long does that fear last? Okay, get a hit in. Get a hit in. There you go. dead. Damn it, I'm dead. Damn it. Load game. Let's go with... with the autosave. Talk to the scary dragon. Where's the word now? Can I offer anything in exchange? Can you offer immortality? The word sustains me, it's life itself. There is nothing you can offer in trade, mortal. How does this world exist inside a snow globe? I cannot begin to explain the magic I used to create this realm to a creature so pitiful as you. Suffice to say, this realm is mine. Credit using the ancient word of the... Okay. And how'd you end up in a snow globe? I am ancient beyond comprehension. Even the reckoning, by the reckoning of my dragonkin, we wavern's worms are not immortal. Though it may seem to a short-lived creature such as you. When I first felt the fingers of Enfimut creeping through my flesh, I vowed I would not sit idly by to await my inevitable end. I created this world for myself. It is a haven where I'm safe from the ravages of time. But that doesn't explain snow globe. Can it begin? Oh, well. Okay, I love how he's not... he's screwed up. It's what it sounds like is he's screwed up. Something else. Can you tell me anything about the dwarves? They are my creations, my servants, my slaves. I gave them eternal life when I built this realm, that they might serve mine every need. But my needs are few, and it is rare that I am forced to call upon the creatures for their service. It has been many centuries since I last spoke with them, and now they only cower in fear or flee in terror at my approach. Why are they always fighting each other? Slaves must have an enemy. If they do not, they will turn against their master. I learned this once long ago. The dwarves and dryads were plotting against me. I gave them existence, eternal life, and they dare to conspire to defeat me. I could have destroyed them, but they are my servants. I won't be destroying my own property. Instead, I bound their loyalties to this realm so that neither dwarf nor dryad would ever work against it. Together again. And they have each other to hate, and I left in my peace. I should go. Alright, let me go talk to... can I at least go talk to... one of them? Oh! Broken Amulet of the Ages. Hairline crack runs through the center of this amulet, the only flaw in its otherwise perfect construction. On the side are inscribed strange symbols from a long-forgotten language, and on the other is the engraving of a dryad's tree and a dwarven hammer. Oh, wait a minute. Do we need to fight him? Because, to be honest, I don't know if I can... I really don't think I can kill him. Not without a huge financial burden on me.
Did you welcome my...
What do you make of this amulet? I mean, it looks familiar, as if I knew it once long ago. The inscription on the back is written in an old and ancient tongue, yet I know what the words say. Tree and forge united to overthrow the master. Hey! Whoa! Whoa! Oh, sorry! Damn it! Let me guess. Effortless, yes. I can't get him to beat the crap out of him. Get to the bearded ones! What? No! Okay, can we try that again? Oh, wrong one. Can I? Cannot talk. Object is busy.
I bid you welcome.
Okay, so amulet. Tree and forge united to overthrow the master. I sense that once this amulet held the great magic, the power of nature itself was contained within. But it's cracked and the magic within is gone. Can you do anything to fix it? Perhaps I can imbue with the magic of tree and earth if it were the whole. But the amulet is cracked and it must be repaired before I can fill it with magic. However, metallurgy is beyond the skill of I or my sisters. The dwarves may possess such power, but they will surely attack you inside if you try to reason with them.
Leave me, foul creature.
Okay.
I will not allow this.
I will not allow this. Okay. Maybe I can try to talk to Hod. Arwell's Fountain. Oh, he's just an angry boy. Hey, look, buddy. How do I get you to realize what needs to be done? Okay, shooting him is probably not going to be the way. Alright, hold on. Let me run away. Damn it. Need to heal up. I need some way. I think that goes back to... back here. Let me go and rest. We're not strong enough. Whoa! There we go. That was weird. Lights just decided to change color. So we're not strong enough. Now the dwarves are friendly. Okay, I like that. Hey! Now that is awesome. I can get behind that. Oh, me name be.
Leader of this dwarven clan. We don't see your kind around here much, but at least you ain't attacking us on sight like them crazed dryads.
That sounds like Steve Bloom if I ever heard it.
Is there something I can help you with?
Why are the dryads? Have you seen this amulet?
Aye, tis a pretty thing, indeed. And it looks, familiar. As if it were known to me long ago. You see the fancy writing on the back? An old and ancient tongue. Tree and forge and united to overthrow master.
Stemmet was forced to hold great magic, yet I see it be cracked. Can you do anything to fix it?
Aye, I can suppose I could repair the crack, but it's simply enough for me to cast a mending spell on ye. Stand back while I work.
Yeah, I should be whole again. Though it should be lacking the magic to make it true. Me glad know the secrets of magic, aye, but only the power of fire, forge, and hammer. Aha. I will be right back. Okay, if I can weaken said badass dragon to then beat the crap out of bad.